trade has arranged with Harrods an exhibition showing the housewife how to turn old things into something quite different and good as new. For instance, the new mother may be at her wit's end, how to get a cot for the little treasure. Well, if you can get hold of some old sacking, it's quite easy. Not perhaps the frilly vision you had in your mind's eye, but it doesn't cost any coupons, nor does the baby. Now, baby, good behavior, please. There's a little gadget that enables sewing machines to darn huge holes in a few minutes. Perhaps they'll soon invent something for attaching bits of new material between the darns. Well, when it comes to clothes, make do and men needn't be at all unfashionable. Listen to what you can do.
Here is Mrs. Quilty on her way to the bathroom. She's wearing a patchwork dressing gown made of odd pieces of material. The lining was formerly a dust sheet. Her pajamas are made from pieces of material found in the attic, presumably great-grandmama's bed valance. Mrs. Clark made her frock from a pair of her husband's old plus four trousers and half a yard of new material. Here is Rita on her way to school. She's wearing a frock made from odd pieces of material. Her coat was formerly her elder sister's, remodeled for Rita's use, and the hat made from pieces of material left over. There's not much use for men's dress clothes these days. Mr. Weston found his didn't fit him when he came home on leave, so Mrs. Weston made herself this costume. The long pockets were the chief difficulty. These she overcame by inserting a narrow belt. I would like to end with a reassurance to women and a warning to men. To the ladies, you may be reassured that all garments made in make, do, and mend are entirely exclusive. To the men, lock up your favorite old clothes before you leave home in the morning.